Beach Fire Department, my brother-in-law, Bud Alava, the fire chief here, his name's Nick. Just wanted to take a minute to acknowledge the first responders, some of them, you know, there's the police, there's the EMTs, there's the fire departments, there's emergency work, nurses and doctors, and really want to take a moment to acknowledge that these people, you know, picked these careers. A lot of them knowing they were going to put their lives on the line, you know, several times in their lifetime, you know. And just want to take the time to acknowledge that and show our appreciation for what they do. Hi. What's up, guys?
How you doing?
Just introduce yourself. I explain why we're here. We're just here to check in and show our respects. Appreciation for what you guys do, and just kind of give people a look into your world. Maybe just introduce yourselves.
I'm Jeff Boyles, I'm the fire chief, but I think he's really here to thank these guys. They're actually the ones on the front lines doing it.
Well, you did your time on the front line.
I did. Sure. I did some time.
I'm Jim Reidler, I'm a fire engineer.
Parker Gonzalez, fireman.
Want to field that one?
This is Matt Reese. Okay.
Yes.
And this is my brother-in-law, Nick Lucas. if you guys could just tell us what it's been like, how it's changed your lives, you know, what it's been like the last few months. You know?
I think the biggest thing is it's really changed how we do business. Obviously, we're staying a little closer than we should be staying, so we like to be respectful of others and shake hands, and that's really changed even just that component of just being a normal human being. But as far as call-wise, we really have done a phenomenal job, at least the guys on the floor, bending over backwards and making sure they're empathetic to people's concerns, which as a team, it has united us even more. So call volume's a little down because people aren't calling for a lot of things. But as far as a concern, as far as other things go, still ramped up. Our call volume is actually down because people aren't out doing what people do. They're not crashing cars, they're not falling off bicycles, they're not going to bars and getting in car fights. People aren't going to work and having anxiety and heart attacks and things like that. So in a weird way, it's dropped off from that part. But the part that they are going on has really ramped up from the precautionary and if you will, like the scary part of it, you know, the fear of the unknown.
Yeah. What about, just a rumor I heard that domestic abuse was up during all this. Is it?
There's been some hints of some of those in-home.
You know, guys turning into Jack Nicholson at home, yeah. Like The Shining.
People are cooped up.
Yeah.
People are cooped up for sure. I think the biggest thing to help a lot of people is if you didn't have a routine before at home as far as like working out and doing healthy stuff, make sure you do that. You know, make sure you get a workout in, make sure that you take that time to breathe a little bit, take a walk around the neighborhood, be mindful of social distancing, and that way the stress doesn't get to you being in the house all day.
Get your mind, you know. I've been reading a lot of, you know, articles in the New York Times about these just emergency room workers and, you know, just the high volume of stress and death.
That takes its toll on them for sure because we just pick them up and take them and now we're done with that individual for that amount of time, but now you take them to the hospital and there's a lot more stress, I think, for them than anything for us because we can kind of isolate them and how we transport them. Mm-hmm. But now you get to a hospital, it's like, hey, we have to isolate a whole wing or we have to have one person that's doing this, and that could be a lot of pressure,
yeah,
you know, a lot of stress for that person. And then they got to go home too, to a family.
sure. Yeah, and this article I read was this nurse has been working, you know, 12-hour shifts, holding people's hands while they die, and for, you know, for a month of that, you know, the accumulative effect, you know, she just goes home and cries.
Yeah,
it was just a heartbreaking story. I want to just take a look at the truck real quick. It's been a while since I've seen it.
This is a fire engine.
Fire engine.
So as you look at it, I mean, this is just a cap for, this is where the firefighter sits. So we always make sure that we have everything that we need to take care of any emergencies. One of them is hand sanitizer. So hand sanitizers and gloves, that's the biggest part of our day. So that's where this individual sits. So you can see too, we got all our fire gear.
What is this guy?
This is where the captain sits.
Okay.
And they control everything when it comes to an incident for the most part. So they route it and everything, yeah.
Calls come in on the NBC there. Jump up there.
So that's where we get our calls, our information, you know, what type of call, what the address is, what are the kind of search, you know, situations kind of going on, especially now with, you know, all the COVID and things like that. We'll get specialized notes on there saying advanced precautions or things like that because they have signs and symptoms of the COVID going on.
Right.
So we kind of get known ahead of time. So it changes our response a little bit. You know, we've always dealt with communicable diseases, but now you're just a little more cautious on every call.
Sure.
Extra PPE that we're doing, extra layering and stuff, but it's nice that we can communicate with that. He route the call, so when we show up, I try and make you know, contact with the people. Hey, are you able to come outside? Can we maybe meet out front in open areas, something like that, while my guys in the back or gals are getting, you know, dressed up and ready to go for the incident.
Awesome. Yeah. I'd like to do a ride along.
Yeah, absolutely. We'll be at the next show. We'll be in the pit.
I'll be there.
He's scared of going to the pit.
I don't want to go home with an injury.
We're only going to go in the pit for Mommy's Little Monster. Don't drag me down. Glenn Helen, familiar where that is now.
Oh, yeah.
You guys were out there a couple summers ago, right?
Sure.
Bring the Gilbert, a couple of the bands out there.
Or
some best ones out there a couple years ago.
10 seconds ago.
Yeah.
Very cool. All right, you guys. Be safe.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.